tryna feed my be my. I'm supposed to make it out and I don't bring my thing. No way, no way, no way, yeah. I think they ones and they here to stay, yeah. I heard these always hating, said I never make it. I heard these always talking with them. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, yeah. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, yeah. I heard he's mad at me cause I'm getting money. I heard he's mad at me cause he's on me. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, yeah. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, yeah.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We have two teams in today's game with plenty of confidence as they're riding big-time winning streaks. It's the Texans going up against the Titans.
We welcome all of you to Nissan Stadium on the banks of the Cumberland River in downtown Nashville, Tennessee. The whole of downtown Nashville likely still reverberating with the sounds of the Titans taking the field a moment ago. They're ready for football as their Titans are set to match up with the Houston Texans. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here's the rookie from Texas, Deontay Foreman. Space to maneuver at the 40. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first.
So much of this game is still mental, still psychological. Yeah, we just saw a big-time run right there. But you have to believe he was dreaming about this last night in his hotel room before this one, thinking, hey, first time I touch it, let's go for some big yardage and set a tone. That's exactly what he got done.
Running this with a wide receiver, Fuller. Room to run inside the 40. Will Fuller, nobody there to stop him. Touchdown, Houston. Will Fuller, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Texans have taken the early lead. So a big-time scamper there to cap a touchdown on the opening drive.
Sets a tone, establishes not what you'd call a dominance, but a really good feeling for the team that just scored. But I've got to ask you, partner, what do the analytics say about that type of a run? Does it establish anything else for them?
To return, here's Michael Campanaro. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop. The 23-yard line. This one goes nowhere, losing yardage back at the 22. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. To throw is Mariota. Buying time to his left. And he is knocked down and then landed on pretty awkwardly. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
The best quarterbacks that ever played the game all wanted to blend in with their teammates and be one of the guys. But sometimes you got to take modesty and put it aside. You're the franchise quarterback, the face of the team, and the guy that leads them to victory. You have to get down and protect yourself and not take hits like that.
Derrick Henry. Despite the heavy running, he'll be hit and drop shy of the 45. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
Oh, a design run for their wideout. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 2.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. So 3rd and 2, this quite possibly 4-down territory, though, if they're stopped. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
They tried to run right into the teeth of the defense on 3rd down, but looked like those teeth were pretty sharp.
They were having absolutely none of it. Stuffed him for a loss.
Yeah, couldn't get any leverage up front and move people aside in order to run the ball.
And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. And they'll be looking to make this a 2-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up 2 scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did some of that.
And he goes nowhere. He'll lose yardage back at the 17. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down. On 2nd down, here's Watson going for the deep ball. He's got a man complete, and all the way down to the 37. A huge play there for Houston, 46 yards. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun, fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. To throw is Watson. Caught. It's Ellington. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield. Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get them in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans. Sometimes those tight ends are a mismatch. They found the mismatch there.
And that's exactly why you want to draw up those types of plays, because coverage is just going to go to the natural guys, the guys that make the big plays on the outside. But if you work your tight end into it, that's a tough one for a defense to handle.
Tough. They couldn't handle it. It worked out for six. And it's good to make it 14-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Now, Deion Lewis to return. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And the Titans getting set to go. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board. Second down here after the incomplete pass. From the gun, Mariota. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
So the D-line's going to spread out. Mariota to throw it. And he hits his man, Matthews. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A really good pickup of 28 yards. First down, Mariota. Sets up the screen to Lewis. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. Only three there on the screen at second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
And that one almost intercepted. Call it a 50-50 ball. It falls incomplete and now third down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Here's Mariota. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. And did he have enough? He did. He kept it online and managed to tuck it into the bottom right corner. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. So it's a seven-play drive, but it stalls out in the end.
Let's credit the defensive front seven. They were a little leaky at the start of the drive, but they stiffened toward the end.
And now out comes Houston. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Hoping now to get back in the end zone on this fourth possession. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They go play action here on first down. Forced out to his left. A pickup of 11 and a Texans first down.
Obviously a big play was needed. And you can see his eyes light up as he realized there's absolutely no one in front of him. And he takes off and goes a long way. Not only does he pick up a first down, but a big gain to boot.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this up to about the 40. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and it's Texans football as we get going in quarter number two. They've got a second down at 5 here to start things out. Back to throw, Watson. Griffin's got it, middle of the field. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Watson hands this to Foreman. Just a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down.
From this vantage point, they've got the lead here, so for me, that'd be enough to go ahead and punt the football and let my defense defend the long field.
If you go for it, you don't get it, then you really put your defense in a tight spot.
Yeah, but we never know what people ultimately will decide to do here on fourth and inches.
And this one's out of bounds. Should be inside the 10, I think it is, at the 6 yard line. We remind you, coming up later tonight, we got a good NFC battle. The Eagles and Seahawks from Seattle, coverage starting at 8:30 Eastern. And tomorrow we'll put a bow on Week 13 with an AFC North matchup between the Steelers and the Bengals from Cincinnati.
A hard-hitting battle right there.
They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll take this one up to about the 13. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Second down, Mariota. But it's caught on the right side, it's Smith. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make... It's second down. Keep it on the ground. This time it's Henry. It's a loss of 2. Now third down.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
The Titans on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Mariota. And this one caught by Delanie Walker. And he'll get it down here to the 43. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. They'll run for it with him. with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. Clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and ten. After the penalty, it's Henry. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled them up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
This time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and that's going to bring up a third down. Walker, the tight end, in motion. Throwing is Mariota. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
These guys had to settle for a field goal their last time moving the ball down the field. They may have to do it again on this drive. That could be frustrating.
Yeah, I don't want to be cliche, but at least they were able to get three last time. Three here, not the worst thing in the world.
And Succop will put this one right through. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
It's a very short kick, taken right at the 20. And now running right through it. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. And now out comes Houston. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
A run by Foreman to start the drive. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
To throw on 2nd is Watson. Throw left side complete. That's Griffin. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give them a new set of downs. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to Tennessee after this. First down throw, Watson. The ball is out. Watson lost it. It's picked up by the Titans. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk-reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football.
So should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the same play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. First down.
This is intercepted. Picked off here by Aaron Colvin. And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. And put it on the board. It's six, a touchdown. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
And here comes the Texans now. Extra point attempt here still to come. They have been red hot, sometimes white hot here in this first half. They're just looking to add to that total right now.
And this has to serve as a reminder to myself because so many times I get wrapped up in the play calling, how they've sequenced things, how it's run. But you know, at the end of the day, it's still execution. Those guys out on the field, and right now they are locked in and really looking good.
They'll try to continue to be locked in here as we get ready to approach halftime. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position now.
Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack. Mariota yelling out the play call as he hustles everyone to get set. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. The Titans on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 17. To throw Mariota. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
This is away, and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. And now out comes Houston. There's really no reason to change what they've been doing to this point. They've got the lead. They've looked good this first half.
I agree with you totally, and a lot of coordinators, play callers feel exactly the same way. Until you stop what I'm doing, why should I make any changes? But there are a few that kind of outguess themselves or try to outguess the opponent. And they try to consider what they would do to take things away and go to those plays right away. It'll be fun to watch when they get to the second half to see which way they go.
Yeah, but to this point, it certainly hasn't been broke. We'll see if they try to fix anything. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Here's Foreman. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Here's Watson. Looking deep downfield. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock.
But one thing's for sure, when you've got a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you got to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. Out of bounds as he appeared to be looking for the corner. He got it. They're going to mark this at the 4-yard line. The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Let's get out of there.
They'll start things on first down with Deion Lewis. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. And apparently that's all, Larry. So much for the halftime report. We'll see you in the postgame. We're ready to get to the third quarter. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. Fresh set of downs here. And he goes in motion here in the backfield. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So they got him coming up from his linebacker spot.
And sometimes the position designation really doesn't matter. If you creep up to the line of scrimmage, you just have to look for the football. Make sure it moves before you do.
Mariota now. Touchdown, Titans! Deion Lewis hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Titans are able to close the gap just a bit. Well, they had their chances in the first half, you remember, but had to settle for 2 field goals. This time, they come away with 6.
I think they actually got affirmation about what they were doing by getting a touchdown, because the field goals means they got in range but couldn't quite finish it all. This time, they broke through, and that's great for the old confidence.
And on the sideline, difference of a feeling between 3 and 6, is it astronomical or no?
It can be at times, that's for sure. A lot of times, the field goal feels like a disappointment. The touchdown, well, that tells you you're getting it done.
Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession, and that was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you'd think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
The drive starts with Foreman on the ground, and running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. Here's Watson now on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass.
Ohio, Ohio, here we go, Ohio. Ohio.
Play action from Miller. Now Watson, flush to his right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver go up and make a big play for me? Can I create a penalty downfield, maybe pick up an interference call and get that yardage downfield? Anything trying to get going again, but you're right. He definitely took a shot.
Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay.
And Henry's hit. He lost the football. And the Texans scoop it. And they are going to take possession of the football inside the 15 at the 14-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
That's complete right around the 8. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Now Foreman. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a 3rd and 5.
Here we go.
Now it's Watson. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, being on the second half, no matter what. Well, this first 5 minutes, first 3, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly
right.
You like
that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
Throwing, Mariota. Throw taken in by Taylor, left side. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. That's a first down pickup for Tennessee on a gain of 10. So the offense has it 1st and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. A solid run on 1st down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Now a 2nd down throw for Mariota. Over the middle, that's caught by Taylor. And now the ball's out, fumble near midfield. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. And you probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down. Mariota now on 2nd down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up 3rd.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
On 3rd down, Mariota, and he locates Walker, complete. A Titan 1st down, Mariota to Walker.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
10th carry now for Derrick Henry. And he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
He's to the 10, and a hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
The Titans on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This will be 3rd and 5. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Mariota. And that's complete to Lewis. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Now a toss play to Lewis. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Deion Lewis with touchdown number 2 in the game and now 11 on the year. And the Titans are able to cut into that deficit. And this one's back to an 8-point game. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get you downfield.
And he's going to be out of bounds up around the 45-yard line. Give him 17 on the pickup there, and the Texans also get a new set of downs.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection.
Let's go!
A carry for Foreman. And he's brought down. Give him 17 on the pickup there, and the Texans also get a new set of downs.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
First and 10, Watson caught left side Hopkins and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Another nice gain, 16 yards there and a first down again.
Ohio. Here we go. Pass 38.
On first down, it's Watson. He couldn't quite hold it, got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player? No chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Let's go, Ohio! 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 Ohio!
They'll run with Foreman. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
And this is why the head coach gets paid the big bucks. Look at where they are in this situation, partner. Do you throw the ball here in a long-distance situation? Do you run it again and trust your defense and make sure you take care of the ball and punt it away? What kind of options do you have here, and what do you trust more on your team?
Yeah, they may have just pushed him back into that throwing situation. We'll see. And it's caught. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. First and goal. Defense back with their backs out, against back the wall. Back round. Here we go. They'll go with Foreman. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the two. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up to the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Again, it's Foreman. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
This offense so far on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and goal. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's in for the score. Touchdown, Texans. A great effort there. Touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Texans will add on to their lead. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
On second down, Mariota again. And incomplete there, a nice hit, jars the ball free and brings up third down.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Mariota from the gun on third down. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. I don't know. He had to be pretty quick with his fingers to start and stop after the ball hit the ground. I'm giving him some credit.
Well, I'm thinking about the mental focus, you know?
Yeah.
Or the mental focus.
Yeah, that's true.
Got to stay with it.
That's true. Desperation time. Mariota on fourth down. Oh, the ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off at the 45, and they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line. And to give this time to the tailback. Oh, now he bowls him over. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out. And by a few inches, that'll be a first down. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. They run again with Foreman, and this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave them with 3rd and still 7 yards to go. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on 2nd down. Faking the give, now Watson. And he goes out of bounds inside the 10 at the 9. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And finding room to work, he's down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 8 and a good first step there with 2nd and goal coming up. They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up 3rd.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
In motion left, the tight end. And they'll run it here. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. They lost a big chunk, 6 yards there, and it leads to 4th down. Now the Texans are going to call on the field goal unit. This to make it a 3-score game late. And his kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. And you figure with that, this game's pretty well out of reach.
It would take a heck of a comeback at this point. Being 3 scores down, I think that's too much to ask with time winding down here in the 4th.
This fielded at the 2. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Call it the 21-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time."
And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by Jonathan Joseph. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And they will score a pick 6 for the Texans TD. You start to feel sorry now for the young man throwing the football. This is really turning into a disaster.
Listen, it's baptism. All right, this is almost a rite of passage. This young in the league, go back and find a Hall of Fame quarterback and check their records for their first 2 years, especially if they started the bulk of the games. I bet you'll find double-digit interceptions on just about every one of them. They have to learn as they go along.
And what a return. Great field position all the way out to the 48-yard line.
Even after that big-time return, it's not looking great for them today. But if nothing else, even if the miracle doesn't happen, they can turn to this play and say, hey, we can move forward. Maybe it's a building block for the rest of the season.
Here's Mariota, and he's going to go down. The Texans come at him and able to bring him to the ground. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up 3rd.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Third and long here for Mariota. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Zach Cunningham with a pick. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. Just a little bit of a rough stretch. Six interceptions now in these last 2 weeks combined.
I know the easy thing is to go back to mechanics, footwork, things of that nature. I'm also wondering, is he getting fooled by what he's seeing on defense? Has the scouting report changed? Are they showing him things different than what he expected? For the second week in a row, he's throwing it to the guys in the wrong color shirts.
Yeah, he better figure, whatever the reason is, he better figure it out. Defense still with three timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. The Texans on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This is third down and 12. Here's a carry for a former starter. This is Lamar Miller. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Now a final chance to stop it here as a timeout comes in with 10 seconds left in the game. Here's Shane Leckler now. He's been terrific so far. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, and that could have been trouble. Things are just going from bad to worse now. It's a safety that does him in here, and that is one frustrated offensive unit.
They can't get out from under their own shadow right now. I mean, I know this is the NFL, but could you imagine a college crowd right now? Imagine what they'd be doing. They'd be chanting, "Start the bus," because they think this one is over.
The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee.